Court is now in session. Please be seated.
Next matter before the court, Commonwealth versus Richard Collins.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead. Mr. President, the plaintiff alleges on yesterday's date in the town of Barnstable. He elaborated on a vehicle under the influence of liquor or more than made a greater cause of homicide. Negligent operation of motor vehicle as well. Leaving the scene after causing personal injury or death. Further count of negligent operation of the motor vehicle, failure to stop infraction, and state highway infraction. Court will enter police with not guilty on your behalf.
Mr. Collins, the clerk has just entered a not guilty plea on your behalf and cast this complaint. Did you ever like to be represented by an attorney? You can either hire your own, but if you can't afford one, court will appoint one for you, or you can represent yourself. Are you looking for an attorney, sir?
Working on it due to the short.
Do you want to hire your attorney?
I will hire my own attorney.
Okay. Well, thank you. Question besides the bail bond.
Your Honor, good morning. Michael Jarry with the Commonwealth. There will be a request for bail as well as condition to release.
Okay. Mr. Collins, I'm actually going over the court officer. There's a bail request. We're going to have an attorney speak to you. We intend to cast the bail. We'll call that case as soon as that attorney does let us know that he's talked to you and he's ready to.
Session, please be seated.
Back to the record there, Richard Collins. Sir, once again, docket number 2225 CR 1450. Alleges on yesterday's date in the town of Barnstable. And he committed motor vehicle homicide by OUI, liquor, or .08 or greater in negligence. Second count, leaving the scene of personal injury and death. Third count, negligent operation of the motor vehicle, and two, infractions, failure to stop or yield to the state highway traffic violation. Not guilty, please, at the door behalf.
Mr. Collins, I understand you've got to hire your own attorney, is that correct? Okay, and I appoint counsel to represent you today, bail only.
Commonwealth. All right, thank you. Commonwealth is requesting a $10,000 cash bail. Also requesting as a condition of the defendant's release that he be ordered to be alcohol-free, subject to a SCRAM monitoring device. Regarding that, it's my understanding that there may not be any available. If that's the case, I'd ask that he be held until one gets placed on him, regardless of whether or not he can post that bail. The request for our bail is based on the nature and circumstances of the offense. Police investigation. It comes from a Barnstable Police investigation. August 16th, 2022, approximately 11:53 in the morning, officers were dispatched to shop, stop and shop. 3900 Falmouth Rd in Marstons Mills was reported a motor vehicle crash involving a motorcycle. As the officers started to respond, they were advised by dispatch shortly thereafter that CPR was being performed on scene in the roadway. Officers responded and observed citizens conducting CPR on the male subject laying in the westbound lane of Route 28. That person was identified as the victim. It was determined that he was operating a 2000 motorcycle with a CERT registration in the westbound lane on Route 28 in the left passing lane through the intersection of entrance of Stop and Shop. Officers spoke with several witnesses who observed the black truck in question that was heading east on Route 28. Witnesses stated the truck took a left turn, lane to enter Stop and Shop. Stated the truck had a red light and the motorcycle had a green light. Witnesses stated the truck cut the front of the motorcycle, causing the motorcycle to crash. The black truck pulled into the Stop and Shop park. According to witnesses, the operator of the truck got out of his vehicle, stared at the victim who was in the road. Witnesses say they took photographs of the truck with partial were able to obtain partial views of the driver. The driver of the truck also denied being involved in the crash with witnesses. The driver got back in his truck and left the scene. Witnesses identified the pickup truck, identified the registration. The operator was described as being barefoot and standing on the street wearing a blue-gray shirt and dark shorts. The police then began looking for the vehicle. The vehicle was ultimately located at a residence in Mashpee that matched the registration of that vehicle. Officers continued to make observations of the house. They also learned in the meantime, shortly after they located the vehicle, that the victim had been taken to Cape Cod Hospital where he was pronounced deceased. The investigation continued. The officers continued to look at the scene, the roadway, etc. The officers determined, based on witness statements and observations at the scene, the black truck failed to stop for the left red arrow traffic light at the entrance of Stop and Shop while heading east on Route 28. The truck turned into the westbound lane on Route 28, causing the motorcycle to bring the car coming right towards the truck. The motorcycle walked up its tires, making skid marks for several feet until the operator lost control. The operator was ejected from the motorcycle, landed in the roadway, causing severe trauma that resulted in his death. The truck failed to stop at the red light and also failed to use the repair and make a turn. Witnesses observed the truck parked in the plaza. The operator get up and stare at the victim laying on the road. The operator then left the crash scene without identifying himself to those witnesses. There are a number of witnesses who didn't interact with him personally. One of them was able to identify him by an RFP photo specifically. They did provide witness statements as well. Officers then, as part of their investigation, went to the residence in which they located the vehicle. They walked up to the front door. They knocked. They observed the male subject who was laying on a couch in a living room. They knocked again. They identified themselves as police officers. The male came to the door. He was identified as Richard Collins, the defendant before you. He did have a dog, who came to the door. Of note, witnesses indicated at the time of the crash, the operator of the truck had a black dog in his motor vehicle. Officers observed at that point Mr. Collins to be unsteady on his feet, he was swaying. I will state that their interaction with him was approximately 2 hours after the accident. Collins did state that he owned the truck. When asked if anyone else drives it, he stated no one else drives it. Asked if he drove the truck that day, he said yes. He stated he went to Oregon Beach and came back to his residence. After speaking with Collins, the officers at that point detected a strong odor of alcoholic beverage coming from his breath. His eyes were bloodshot and glassy. He was slow in answering questions. He did not seem confident in his answers. The officer asked Mr. Collins if he drove to Stop and Shop in Marston's Mills. He stated yes. I asked him if he turned into the plaza and he was going to score. He stated no. He stated he never went into the plaza. They asked if he had any alcoholic drinks that day. At that point, he said no, he didn't. However, he then stated he drank when he got home after the crash, which would be inconsistent with his initial statement that he was there immediately. Officers observed have sand on his legs and feet. He was wearing a blue green shirt with a blue t-shirt. He was advised of his brand and he was placed under arrest. He was booked. During booking, he didn't make many statements. However, the officers did feel he was intoxicated. That's when he claimed that he had not drank alcohol prior to the crash, but only after. With that being said, Judge, as part of the investigation, the police were able to obtain surveillance video from a local liquor store in the area about an hour prior to when the accident would have occurred. The surveillance video of Mr. Collins entering that liquor store, purchasing a bottle of vodka, paying cash for it, and leaving. Those would be essentially the nature of the facts at this point. The investigation still is ongoing. Follow with respect to have additional information presented at a further date. Based on the nature and circumstances of the offense, Judge, appears Mr. Collins has an Ipswich address, most likely a second home here on the Cape. The fact that he stopped his vehicle, he's clear by the witness statements, made observations of the individual laying in the roadway, denied being involved in the accident, then left the scene, made no other attempts to make contact with anyone, who would suggest that a $10,000 bail is highly appropriate in this matter. In light of the evidence of alcohol consumption, upon what was just a scram is even highly appropriate, and ask the court to propose those with a condition that he not be released until the scram is available. If he does post any bail that's set by the court, probation did mention to me or motion to me that there might be one available, but at that point, that's why the mom was making our request, and we ask you to adopt it.
However, he's a 71-year-old individual who has never been in trouble before. Having been asked, he's absolutely no history of going to his house. Not if you're in the court, he's supposed to. While I do believe that Mr. Collins is an excellent candidate for personal cognizance, I'm going to point out that he was released from the police department on his personal cognizance. And he did come in and appear today with his family to face these charges. Nonetheless, given seriousness of the charges, I get a cash bail on $25,000 and then go to $10,000. Does have a second home. Yeah. Does live in Ipswich. He's a professional today, available 30 plus years, hired for about 13 years. Does a home in Marstons Mills here. Comes for about a week every month. So he has a place to go and an app to support. The real question is whether he was going to appeal his charges and his obligations to court. I think he was this morning and walked in the court, not secure in his presence here. As to the request for this hearing, there's no question of his allegations and alcohol, his involvement, or consent to the imposition of the scram requirement. The question that I have is whether or not it's just a hold until there's a scram. This is not a situation where a scram is part of a request under Section 58A. This is an appearance question. He's demonstrated his willingness to be here in the court. It's holding to be for a scram. I would suggest that the court is one of the options. There are alternatives. In the event that a scram can't be brought today, he can send to the GPS and what is being fixed. In the state, with the condition that any scram request is available, can you report down there to the court? But given his lack of history, or the fact that he's ever in trouble, given the fact that he's walking in the voluntary lines of this morning with his family to face these charges, I would suggest that he put $25 cash for the conditions.
License in this case. If not, I'm going to order that you not drive a motor vehicle
Peter Conlon from Massachusetts, pending the outcome of the resolution of this case.
Sir, I show you here to go to court to answer these charges. The board has issued all of $10,000 cash for 100,000-mile surety. Also, the condition that remain alcohol free with the strand. Will be held without bail pending that strand fitment. Also, you are not to drive one vehicle in Massachusetts until the resolution of this case. And also, sir, be aware that you should be charged with any state or federal crime for the pendency of this case. The court could revoke your recognizance and hold you without bail for up to 90 days or more until the time of trial. You also have a right to review the bail sent in this court from the Superior Court in due course. Counsel can explain those rights.
Thank you.
The defendant is not to leave the Commonwealth from Massachusetts. You're also ordered not to leave the Commonwealth until resolution is made. Need a next statement, please.
Now, counsel, he said he's going to hire his own attorney. Can we have a date that gives him enough time?
Your week's time be sufficient, sir?
Mr. Murphy.
9:20.